Hi, I'm Kurt with Traverse Tool Company, and today I need to mount my machine vise on this table, so I thought why not make a video and show you the best way to do it. So of course we can't just plop the machine vise on this table that has the chips all over it. Anything that's on this table before the vise goes on is going to make my workpiece uneven. So let's see how to clean this thing up. I like to use a vacuum cleaner that has a nozzle on it that'll get down in between the T-slots, and I'll start with the top and then get down into the slots. I'm just going to take another step. And I have this stone here that has a 320 grit on one side. I wouldn't recommend using anything any coarser. And some lubricant. This is an oil impregnated stone, but I'm still going to spray it down anyway, as well as the table. And with this, I can feel any drags or snags on the table that might have something raised up, might be a burr. And I don't feel anything. Feels good. Now I'll just take a rag, clean that off. And next I'd like to use my bare hand and just feel the table for two reasons. One reason is you can pick up a little bit more with your hand than you can with a rag. And I want everything off of the table. Also, I can feel if there's anything that I missed with the stone. And it feels pretty good. Okay, the table is just about ready for the vise. I'm going to do the same thing with the vise, just with the stone. I'll stone the bottom of it and prepare the vise for the table. Next thing I do is, because I'm going to have two unprotected mating surfaces clamped together, I'm just going to spray it down with a rust preventative. How do you say that word? Anyway, something to prevent rust. And I'm spraying the vise as well. Here's the vise. Now I already ran my hand across the bottom of the vise, just like I did with the table, and the vise feels good. So I have keys in my vise. You can see the two of them right here. So I gently put those keys into the T slot, and now I'm just going to slide it back and forth. And if there's anything I might have missed, anything that fell out of the vise that might be between the vise and the table, I'd feel it, or it would just run off the vise and stay next to it rather than under it. Now I'm ready to bolt it down. Here I have my T-nuts and studs. Then the washers go on there. And the flange nuts. And then finally, be sure to bolt it up nice and tight. And that's all that's to it. If you want to be sure that you did a good job mounting your vise and that it's true, put an indicator on it and check it. There's a variety of ways to mount an indicator to a machine. You can put a rod up into a collet. I just have a clamp that mounts it right onto the spindle. And I bring the indicator over near the chuck, near the jaw, And then I bring the y-axis back till I see the needle move. And I'm going to leave it right on the zero. Now as I'm moving the vise and the table in the x-axis, I'm just watching the needle to see if it moves. Generally with the keys in there under the vise, you can hold it within a thousandth, maybe even a half a thousandth. If you need it more accurate than that, you might need to do a little bit more work, and I'll show you how to do that in another video. And I have about a thousandth, so that's good for rough work, but for more precise work, we need better than that. But if that's good enough for you, then we're all done here. Thanks for watching, and if you want to know how to indicate the vise that doesn't have the keys in it, there's a sneaky little trick that I'll show you in another video, so stay tuned.